country. And again to Clowney, who's blocked at the rim.
Brandon Miller in this ball game, most likely.
In the paint again.
Alabama moving that ball, get anything they want.
They go under on Sears, and he makes it
from three. Castleton with the mid post.
And he just lost it. Bediako chalk it away, getting up in his airspace. Bediako with the block.
Five out offense. It opens up that floor.
And Brandon Miller in transition finds Clowney. Javon Quinterly for three.
Wow. How much freedom and confidence do those Alabama guards play with?
Mark Sears, the lob. Bediako will clean it up. Top scorer in the SEC. This is Sears with a drive. Uncommon. Here's Griffin for three. Their basketball to go around. They played at a tempo. Did they get so many possessions that there are shots?
Wow. One of the two, right? Bird cut in this game. Alabama did a good job of making guys cut through their chest.
Quinterly. Miller's hounded by Richard. Whoa, that's a high percentage look. And possession time, 15 seconds per possession.
He has to get himself free for that look.
Rejection by Bediako. Tied the other way. Miller!
Off at Nate Otez in his mind right now.
Now Miller feeding Bediako.
Cut. Burning the pressure off with a back cut is all it is. Bam! Like Nate Oates and Eric Musselman. Going to keep those guys in this league at Oklahoma, Texas.
Whoa, what a pass! Regular season tournament every year.
It's not going to go away either under Nate Oates or Bruce Pearl.
Great, but we played a lot more like we're accustomed to playing. That's a good team too. I mean, they look at their last two games and they've been playing their best basketball right now. So, you know, that's one of the teams that's going to finish in the top half of the league would be my guess. So to do that against them, obviously Castleton had a great game. You know, we would have liked to have done a better job on him. He's a really good player, obviously. Did think we did it, you know, we did a good job taking away their threes for the most part. They hit that late one, kind of on a kick down that we gave up, but you know, the first half they didn't hit one. So if you're gonna double, they do have shooters, they take a decent amount of threes. We didn't want to give up a bunch of threes. That's the way to get upset. So our game plan was not to double them when Charles was in there. We probably needed to double a little more when Charles wasn't in there, but you know, other than our defense on Castleton, I thought our effort tonight was pretty good.
Yeah, too, if I can. Obviously, with the stretch you guys have coming up, this is an important first one to get out of the way. But what do you think was key to having guys locked in from the start in this matchup when it would have been easy to look ahead? And also, I mean, that's, I think, the number 10 defense coming in this game in the country. You guys almost put up 100. What was the key there?
You know what? We weren't happy with our game at LSU. I think guys understood we got to play better. That wasn't who we were. And our point was, two out of our last three games, we haven't played hard enough long enough game, or our two lowest that game in Oklahoma game, or our two lowest blue-collar totals. Made a big point emphasis on getting that back up. It was almost 90 tonight. They only had 60, so I thought we played a lot harder. It just, let's get back to being who we are, who we know ourselves to be. And that's us. I thought Jaden Bradley had a great start to the game. You know, offensively, he's getting downhill, making plays. You know, we shot it well. That always helps. But, you know, we out-rebounded them. I mean, I just think when we're locked in and our efforts there, we're a really good team. And guys understand that nobody was happy with that game at LSU. It's good to get a win when you don't play well, but we need to play well. So we came out with the mindset we need to play well. And this is a good team. If you don't play well, they beat you. So we did play well.
Coach, you seem to really emphasize the small ball lineup today with either Brandon Miller or Dom at the 4 and 1 big. Just what was the effectiveness about that? And then in the second half, when the energy seemed a little low, you put Nick Pringle at that foul spot. How was he able to bring that energy off the bench?
Yeah, they play four guards, so we felt like that, you know, we started with the same lineup, and, you know, once we moved Clowney to the five, we pretty much went with Clowney, Charles, or Pringle at the five, which is why Noah Gurley didn't play tonight. It was nothing that, I mean, he's doing fine. We just, he's not a guard, and he'd be our fourth center. So we kind of, once we got away from the starting group, we, you know, in both halves, we pretty much went four guards out there and played either Brandon or Tom Welch, like you said, kind of at the four. We just felt like that was better matchups with what they had on the floor. Defensively, Pringle did give us some quality minutes. I mean, you know, he can obviously play. You know, Charles did well, but Charles got tired and Colin was doing pretty well. So, what did he end up with? Played 12 minutes, ended up with 4 points and four rebounds and two blocks. Like, I thought he did well for us. He played hard. You know, he's been having good practices, so it was nice to be able to reward him with some minutes tonight.
Coach, that's three games in a row now that Quinterly's had five assists. Just what's your assessment of how he's facilitated the offense when he's been in the game as of late?
Yeah, he's been playing. He's getting back into his groove. I mean, me and him talked about it. He's looked great in practice. Best I've seen him since last year. I thought tonight he was great. I mean, when he shoots the ball like he's been shooting it, he's tough to guard because you can't sag him. You got to get up on him, and he can get by anybody. If you have to play him like as tight as you have to play him when he's shooting it like this, he can get in the lane. And once he gets in the lane, I think he's one of the best passers, if not the best in the country. So he's finding people. He's getting assists. He's looking to find, you know, guys when he's in the lane. So it's nice to be able to have him. And, you know, him and Jaden Bradley both had five assists tonight. You know, between the two of them, their two main point guards with 10 assists and only one turnover. So really good point guard play. Obviously helps your offense flow smooth, go along with the shooting we had. So, yeah, I was happy for him.
Welcome in to the Ropes with TR3. This is a show where we do and have fun, have a lot of knowledge, where we, you know, serve y'all this great news, man. We have a good time while doing it, man. I'm your host, the one and only Trent Richardson, and we do have the one and only Super Bowl winner, two-time National Championship Defense Player of the Year, SEC Defensive Player of the Year. We do have Mr. One and Only Reggie Ragland via phone. Reg, what's going on?
Man, what's good? Hey, people, I just want to let y'all know, y'all host Trent Richardson is one of the funniest dudes I've ever met in my daggone life.
Listen, we ain't starting this today. Listen, we got Miss Lisa over here on the 1-2. She helping me with the board today. Lisa, how you doing? There you go. How you doing, Miss Lisa?
I'm good. Where are you, Reggie? I brought you food today.
Oh, you did?
Yep, brought a prime rib sandwich and baked beans.
Oh, man.
And you're not here.
Yeah, I know. I'm going to support my big sister. She coaches at Hoover. The area championship game. And I ain't got a chance to see her coach in about 2 years, so... I'm sorry. Hey, this is what you do.
You good, Trent? Like, eat your food.
Just put it in the freezer and we'll unthaw it and make it.
Ain't nobody gonna eat that.
I will.
I'll bring some fresh.
Hey, Reggie is the funniest person in the world.
Both of y'all are funny.
No, something is wrong with Reggie.
Something wrong with you.
Something wrong with Trent.
Listen. Both of y'all touch, so it don't make a difference.
Little bro took me out last night, man. We went to the Florida game, the Alabama-Florida game last night. Mm-hmm. We had a good time, man. We got to see a lot of people that, you know, that was there when we was in school. A lot of people that, you know, kind of helped us along the way, far as, you know, being our village while we was in school.
Mm-hmm. Savage.
But we definitely had a good time yesterday, man. I laughed the whole game. Especially at halftime.
Okay, give me an example.
Reggie over there laughing. What you laughing about, Reggie?
Because he's sniggling.
I'm laughing at you about to eat that popcorn.
Wait, what? Wait, he was trying to eat popcorn?
He was. You don't tell him. I'm going to tell him shit. I'm sorry.
Somebody tell me.
Listen. This tooth is not gonna be done with until about a year. As far as janking on me, as far as joking on me, so I don't listen. I accept it.
No, but Trent, you set yourself up, bro, for that one. You shouldn't have looked at me the way you looked at me.
What happened?
Go on here, Red.
No. So we at halftime, and you know, there's a bunch of alumni people there. We see Jeff and our old trainer there. We see some of our old teammates. I even seen one of my friends. She worked there too. So I'm talking to her. I didn't see Trent put his hand in the popcorn little bucket he got. And then next thing you know, I just see him stop and look at me. And I'm like, what's going on, Trent? And I'm knowing. He made that. He said, man, I think my dad goes too.
Looking on my teeth.
Wait a minute. It came out.
No, it didn't come out.
Oh.
I went to sucking on my teeth.
Like you did on that video.
Man.
On Instagram.
Listen. That thing.
Did it feel like it was coming out?
Listen. I feel like so I sucked too hard when you. A chance.
Yeah.
And that thing felt like it was just coming out. I looked at Red. And I had to open my mouth. He just bust out laughing. Like, I'm trying to make sure my tooth still
is. Man.
Because I didn't know, was it a kernel?
Yeah.
Or not.
But that's the wrong thing you should be eating.
I know, but.
What are you doing?
Like,
man, but everything was just so accessible to us. And we had apple pie.
Just because it's there don't mean you're supposed
everything
to eat
was
it.
Free.
It don't matter.
Apple pie.
Man, he ate a glizzy.
Man, gone soon. If I made no damn glizzy.
Wait, what's a glizzy?
Well, my side hurt right now.
God,
I hope you. No,
he don't listen.
I'm glad it didn't come out because the way when y'all go somewhere, y'all gonna get a crowd. People gonna have videos on you and everything.
No,
so I'm glad it didn't come out.
Look here, I didn't realize how famous Trent is until we walked out. Man, we walked in the gym. You know, the game already started, so we walking behind the bench. Y'all get to find our seats. So everybody in the whole gym just staring at Trent.
Mm-hmm. That's why I don't like going to war with him.
He was showing me the ropes.
Yeah, exactly.
If that tooth would have fell out yesterday, I was going to have to rope some up my dang self.
Hey, Reggie, yeah. he came to my job, and he walked in. It was like the players' club. Like, even the president and vice president, they all running down the stairs.
Oh, Luke and I. What up, Luke?
Oh,
man,
God,
I ain't tell you. I saw him at her job, right, Reg?
Right.
And you know, Lisa's short. So I'm walking behind Lisa, and I don't even know if you noticed, Lisa. I'm walking behind you, and, like, she got, like, it's some stairs that you can walk underneath if you're short enough.
Oh.
And, like, they're fully cemented, bro.
And so he's following you. You following me.
And so I'm looking at my phone following her, and this thing I know it. Doop. Like, I done almost knocked everything out my brain.
That noggin hit my bottom skull. Of the stairs so hard.
And a little lady at the front desk was like, are you okay? Are you all right? And so I'm playing it off. No, I'm fine. I'm good. I do this all the time. I mean, I'm here a lot. Bro, I get around that corner, bro. Man, that dog on temper started to swell up quick.
Good thing you had that hat on.
Bro.
You know you can't follow me. I can go in small places.
Trent can't go nowhere with that hair.
That's
what it is. And it's back big, so, man.
they love
them big back brothers now.
Man, we sitting there. So I walk over there with Reggie to go get something to eat. Mm-hmm. Smitty, you crazy, bro. He putting up Michael Jackson and Thriller when he eating the popcorn in the movie theater. He's so wild, bro.
I can't stand
Smitty. Get on my nerve, bro. So we go over there. I go over there to get some to eat,
mm-hmm.
And Reggie walk off. So I'm like, oh man, I'm gonna give me some to eat right quick.
Mm-hmm.
Tell me, a group of people just came and attacked me, and Reggie over there, he done made him a burger. He done ate. He done had
man,
some
you know
little chicken pig dog. What chicken?
Man,
buffalo wings.
It was some pig wings.
Pig wings.
Pig wings. What are those?
Swine.
I don't know what it was, but it was all right.
Man, listen.
It was good.
That thing ain't say whack whack. That thing said.
Good. Good thing you weren't getting. He was not getting jumped because he was over there.
Man, listen. If I was getting jumped.
My mom always told me, you always try. So if you don't like it, you ain't got to eat it. I damn sure tried that day.
Yeah,
that's true. He walked past on some. Well, you get some of these wings. I don't know what these is. These little pig wings right here. They good. So I'm going over there to just find something to eat because I know it got different stuff over there. So yeah. I'm like, I'm going to grab me something. Mm-hmm. Soon as I turn that corner, they skipped Reggie, or Reggie ran off and left me over there with everybody.
And you can't get away.
I did not see you walk away.
And I can't. That's
right.
Just me.
Yeah.
I'm talking about set me up on a rookie deal. Like,
no, you set yourself up for walking over there.
That's something for you. Okay. All right.
Because he can't walk away.
I did not see you walk over there because when I walked back, I'm like, damn. I'm like, dang, where Trent go? And they were like, he went and got some eating. I'm looking. And next thing you know, I done finally seen him. He got about 8 people around him.
Red, you ain't say, man. You need to get some of them wings, man. You ain't say that.
After the, yeah, when they finally walked off, I walked over there.
Did you try them?
No, it was pork.
So you knew it was pork.
Yeah, it's,
okay,
it was pork.
Did,
so
it look like wings?
No, it looked like regular chicken wings.
That's weird. I have never
like
heard
small
of that.
Party little chicken wings.
Yeah,
but it said pork wings or something like that,
I'm
or
good.
Porky wings or pig wings.
Mm-hmm. And I shouldn't have ate it, but my stomach didn't agree with me after the fact. But man, it was good going down.
Some damn pork shaped wings. The wing shaped pork.
I'm talking about if they didn't have a sign up there, you would have thought you were eating every bit of chicken.
So
and whatever they sauced it with.
Yeah.
Man, Reggie, you know, you get a napkin or you know, you get your little baby wipe or something in public. Reggie would why come in the kitchen? With a goddamn refrigerator.
She's eating up all the pig wings.
All the hog balls.
I like pig feet. Gotta coordinate.
Well, overall, it sounds like y'all had a good time, though.
Oh, yeah, we had a great
time. Yeah, man, trip funny, man.
Are you going to be here tomorrow?
Yeah, I'll be here tomorrow. I'm just at the game right now. It's at Hoover High School.
Okay, I'm going to make some curry chicken, and I'll bring it in.
Curry chicken, I would definitely be there with a beer about and 2 fingers moisturized so I can go ahead.
It's not going to be spicy. I didn't say jerk chicken. I said curry chicken.
As long as it ain't spicy, I can eat it. Jeez. As long as it ain't spicy, I can eat it.
I don't really make curry chicken spicy.
Hey, have y'all ever ate at Jake's in Hoover?
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Man, Jake's is fire.
Yeah, Jake's real good. So, Reggie being back, he just been trying out every little restaurant he can.
Everything.
Yes, what the restaurant have you tried last night? Remember, what was the restaurant you tried to order last night, Thompson? Man, they say you're supposed to close at 11, man. It's 10:50. I can't believe they ain't taking my order.
It was a ramen bar spot that I went to the other day.
Oh, shoe shop.
I knew it was shoe shop.
Shoe shop.
Yeah, shoe shop.
What you say? Shamaki.
Man, they got good drinks in there, too.
They close early, don't they?
They close at 11.
Yeah, but I think it's later on the weekend.
Yeah,
because I know we were me and my friend were there one night, and she and I didn't leave till like what, after 12:30, something like that.
Yeah, it's a cool little spot. Dark, it's intimate. It's cool to take your little.
It's very dark. You need a flash.
Yeah, you got your lady. You take her in there.
It's that dark.
Mm-hmm.
You got the
mud dust in
there. Like the lights are off.
It's dark like that.
Yeah, it's dark.
Mm-hmm.
Dark.
You don't want nobody to see you know who you with. That's a good place to go.
Exactly.
That
if you
want to
go
in
the Lolo,
make it make sense.
That's the Lolo place.
Make it make sense. That's why the food prices and drinks so good, huh?
I sat at the bar by myself.
Uh-huh. Yeah, I didn't know it. But listen, we got to take a break, man. We're going to... elaborate on the game when we get back, man. We definitely we know Reggie at the game right now, supporting Hoover. Crystal over there doing her thing with the coaching. She's holding it down. She's been over there for a few years now, and she done won a couple championships too. What was it? How many she done won? Two or three?
They won last year.
I know they won last year, man.
I love seeing female coaches, especially.
But
especially
Crystal,
sisters.
Crystal, man, Crystal's special with it, man. She got
especially
those
us.
Kids have definitely buying into the process over there, man. Listen, so we'll be right back. We definitely got a bill to pay. I'm going to give it to Reggie to pay these bills since he was laughing at my tooth that almost came out last night. And he did me bad last night, but we had fun, man. Listen, we'll be right back with the Ropes with TR3.
We'll be back.
Join a team you know and love at WDJC and WXJC. We're looking for a part-time receptionist and assistant to the office manager to share your enthusiasm and skills with us. This position is multifaceted, from helping WDJC and WXJC listeners, advertisers, and broadcast partners to performing a variety of administrative duties. If you're eager to serve and have a heart for ministry, apply today and earn the extra cash you need. We offer competitive pay at a company that's making a difference. See the full job description at WDJCOnline.com. Send your resume to LDS@CrawfordMediaGroup.net. That's LDIAZ at CrawfordMediaGroup.net. If you qualify for this position, our office manager, Lesvia Diaz, will set up an interview with you. Crawford Media Group is an equal opportunity employer.
Live from AVX Studios in downtown Birmingham, The Ropes with TR3.
Inspired by quality ingredients and excellent service, Edgar's Bakery has been a staple of Alabamian celebrations since 1998. What started as a small neighborhood bakery, founded by Terry and Dottie Smith in Birmingham, has expanded to 10 locations throughout Alabama. Edgar's Bakery offers hot, delicious breakfast and lunch options, in addition to grab-and-go deli items. They offer a wide range of pastries and desserts, including cookies, bars, brownies, cakes, cupcakes, and much more, made entirely from scratch, using fresh, natural ingredients. Shop for gifts and merchandise in-store, including everyday and seasonal home decor items. Edgar's has something for everyone. They also offer catering, shipping, and delivery options. Visit their website today at edgarsbakery.com or stop by a location near you.
Walk On Sports Bistro puts everything they've got into bringing you game day with a taste of Louisiana. Dig into their mouth-watering, made-from-scratch Louisiana dishes or fan favorites like juicy burgers and fresh salads, all in front of 70-plus TVs with more than 40 beers on tap. Watching at home? Walk-Ons is available to go. Order online or through the Walk-Ons mobile app. Visit Walk-Ons in Tuscaloosa, Hoover, Montgomery, and Mobile. Walk On Sports Bistro, more than a restaurant.
Hey Birmingham, thinking about making your next move? The Randy Brooks team at Avast Realty is ready to help you with your real estate needs. If it's buying or selling, they have the tools and expertise to get you from for sale to sold. Whether you're looking in the city or want space to stretch out, call us at 205-965-6645. That's 205-965-6645. Real estate is key to building long-term wealth, so call the Randy Brooks team at 205-965-6645 and let's get you from for sale to sold today. 205-965-6645. Your dream has an address. Let's find it. New construction home searching can be challenging for buyers. The solution is the Avast Realty New Construction Home Team at 205-965-6645. Their relationships with the top new home builders in the state means they have the most up-to-date information on new home inventory. And as your buyer agent, the Avast Realty New Home Construction Team will give you 1% of our commission to use towards your new home purchase. So put the knowledge, expertise, and professionalism of the team to work for you and contact the Avast Realty New Construction Team at 205-965-6645 today. Again, that's 205-965-6645. Call today because your new home is waiting. Commission share disclosed on sales contract and closing statement.
Excuse me, do you know how long halftime is for a Crimson Tide football game?
15 minutes?
12 minutes?
18 minutes?
I'm pretty sure 12 minutes.
Actually, halftime at Alabama lasts 20 minutes. Any idea how long it takes to complete a mortgage application?
An hour and a half.
Probably like 3 hours at least.
It takes a couple days.
I'm going to go with 45 minutes.
Actually, at Assurance Financial, you can apply for a mortgage in less time than halftime. Find out more by visiting them at AssuranceMortgage.com. That's AssuranceMortgage.com.
Equal housing opportunity, NMLS 70876.
Call Chase Brooks at 205-612-4046.
We'll be right back.
Welcome back with the Ropes with TR3. And you do have the one and only Reggie Ragland. Reg, you pulling up to the game, man. I know we went to the game last night, man. What was it was a special night, man. What was so special about that team, about Bama team last night, man? I know you was impressed by a few guys, and I see it ain't that easy to impress you last night, man. We couldn't get no reaction out of you. You kind of got the same reaction and I guess facial expressions as I do when it comes to sports and you know, not being easily impressed, man. And so who impressed you last night and what you see for the team that they did great last night and a couple things that they can work on, if there's anything they can work on?
Man, they did good. Like, you could tell when they own, they play good together. You could tell they like playing with each other, you know what I'm saying? But I can always think they can get better at playing defense, moving their feet, things like that, man. But that's a good team, bro. And if anybody listening is on that team, I'd love for them to just understand, like, y'all just got to keep being mentally strong and tough as it go on, because you're going to face adversity trying to go win a championship. Everybody faces adversity. Like, you might be down 10 with 3 minutes to go, but who's going to dig deep and help pull it out by playing a little extra hard on defense or anything like that, man? And the guys who aren't on and scoring-wise, like, you got to figure out a way to another score just instead of shooting threes, man. Get some going to the basket and seeing the ball go in the hoop a few times. And then start back shooting your jumpers, man, then make you get back comfortable in the flow of the game. But for the most part, man, I like – That mug, Brandon, that man, that butt Brandon, he sorry. But all of them boys rebounds. Can play, man.
Yeah, he had 9 rebounds, 3 assists, 24 points last night.
Sheesh.
And it was so effortless and easy. That's the thing. It was effortless.
Yeah, yeah.
I want to see, like, it's cool to hoop like this now, but I want to see what you're going to do in the tournament when it's all, when it's nut crunching time.
Mm.
That's
what
I
want to
see.
Right,
you
going to
dig deep and go get that thing.
Yeah, I seen him go up last night, man. Hey, boy, jumping out the gym now to be that height, too, man. You know, it ain't a lot of 6'9", 6'10 dudes out there jumping like he jumping. So, I was.
Right, he's just, long as I don't get out.
Yeah, he long. For me personally, man, I like to see the guys with a little bit more meat on their bones far as, you know, I know they, you know, everybody got the new sports night down there in Alabama and Tuscaloosa. But, you know, get a little meat on their bones, man. So when they crash the boards, man, they're not getting pushed around. And I know, they hold their own down there. But I definitely think when you're not on, as far as the three-pointer, we got to be able to, you know, crash the boards, make layups, be able to be bully ball, you know, have bully ball when you're dunking on somebody. Let them know when they come through there, if you're going to foul them, you really sending them to the line. They're going to have to earn them 2 points, because if they ain't earning it, man, they shouldn't be scoring it, you know? So, you know, when it come down to being physical, I would love them to be more physical. And they played a tremendous game last night, man. That boy Sears, man, that point guard. Shh.
North Alabama, baby.
Oh, he's from your neck of woods, huh?
Yeah,
he's Mark Sears, I think. Yeah, Mark Sears, he had 19 points, 2 rebounds, 1 assist. But, man, when he got in his groove, bro, when he did that, he drop-stepped that thing. When he stepped back, hee-hee, she-she.
No,
you
talking about
corner. No, I'm talking about
Sears. What's up,
the one with the fro.
Yeah, it's Sears, but I like Quinley, too.
Oh, no, I'm talking about Quinley. Yeah, that's what I meant, Quinley. Seriously, yeah, he drops on too now. But that dog on Quinley, yeah, Quinley's something special, man. That young fella is special. And he plays so quiet. Like I know when I played basketball, that was like the only sport I taught mess in. because it's kind of like you got to get into somebody here. And I guess that's because that's the only time I really got to play defense. Mm-hmm. But like far as... like sports, like I would talk missing that. I would talk some missing track, you know, because I knew that, you know,
so you
that was an individual.
Football?
No, I never taught missing football.
Really?
No, even when folks was like mouthing off at me, yeah. I just look at them. The farthest they get out of me is like, man, just don't make me mad. And I get back. Yeah, you're right.
And like, that's scarier than anything. Quiet, when people are quiet like that, mm-hmm. and just say one thing in a monotone voice, that'll make somebody think twice.
Yeah, I mean, because, it was too much. You know, I'm trying to scold, trying to run somebody over, mm-hmm. or trying to run past somebody. So that's already a lot. Yeah. Like, I ain't got time to go back and forth with you. Like, I'm trying to catch my breath, think about this next play.
But that play over with. But you in your head, too, anyway, right?
Yeah, I mean, yeah, you get people like that all the time, especially defensive guys. Defensive guys would definitely try to get underneath your skin. I mean, you got some receiver. I done heard some of the mouth and receiver. Like, Marquise Mays, man, listen, every game we about to fight because of little dog. And, you know, and it'd be from the guys that from – he from Birmingham, so he'd be talking like, we played Tennessee, mm-hmm. and this had to be our last year in school. And man, he was going so hard on the board. Just, I'm dogging y'all. I'm fit to dog you. You sorry you ain't from no Birmingham. You this and that, man. You take your sorry. Blah, 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 blah. I'm talking about going at they net. Like,
did he get to him?
And he definitely got to him. Because every play they would come to me, man, you better get your homeboy. And so at this time, man, F y'all, this my dog. What you doing wrong with you? Get him for what? What you ain't gonna do nothing? And we finna come dog y'all the next play. But that was just like the energy that he gave us too, you know, like, but I done been around some receivers like that. That was their job. Their job was to go out and make sure that they get into the defender head, like and make sure that they got them out their game. Mm-hmm. Like, and I would tell people all the time, if that's what you good at, talking mess. Yeah. You can get underneath somebody's skin, then do that to your best ability.
Yeah, do it to your opponent. Like hard. Hard.
Yeah, I ain't got time for that. It's too much breathing and running going on.
See, I'm like you. I ain't got time for all that. I can't do it. But, man, listen, you got some guys out there would just go hard on that. You know, I'm for to get on these skin. I'm for to see who I'm going to make my little, I ain't going to say the word, beep, beep, and beep. But that's how you choose your game. That's how you play your game. Because I know, you know, once, like I was a mind person. Like, I was more of a mental guy when I played ball. Mm-hmm. And so if I knew I had a weak, like you had a weakness, like, I was going to be that alpha dog of the game, the whole game, but I was going to conquer you in a different way. I was going to, like when you talk about LeBron mentally messed people up.
Yeah.
Like, LeBron, like, even Jordan at the time, he would do that too. But, like Kobe would mentally beat you.
Yeah. And talking or just performing?
Both. Okay. Talking and performing. Mm-hmm. But, like, Kobe didn't really talk much mess or even, like
he was even.
yeah, but Jordan would tell you like, all right, young fella,
and that's it.
Yeah, it's done with. Like, you can hear guys all the time talk about, you know, Kevin Garnett. He was talking mess to Jordan. They was winning, and Jordan had told him, you're like, all right, young fella, it's over with now.
A word, all right, young fella. Boy, I love that when he talked.
And went back and hit like 24 on him.
Ain't have nothing to say.
Nah. Who was talking about Kobe, man? They were saying that they was doing Kobe pretty bad. And, what's Tiana Taylor's husband name?
Iman.
Iman, yeah. He was like, bro, I'm in here doing them. Like, I'm talking mess to him. And he sit there and say, it's over, young fella. He said, man, next thing you know, Kobe throwing off the back. He throw the ball off the backboard, passes to himself, dunk. So he like, bro, like, what are you on right now? Like, are you serious?
But just saying it like that'll get in somebody's head. Like, it's over.
Yeah.
What you mean it's over? What you got going on?
Oh, you want me to play you for real? All right. Cool. Like, I do that in a video game. Like, when I play my son.
Yeah.
Like, TJ's pretty good at the dang game. Mm-hmm. And, man, he'll be beating me, right? And I'll be like, you done yet?
Trying to get in his head.
And I come back on him and end up beating him. And he'll be, you know, he's looking at me like, bro, like, how you do this every time on that 2K? I can't mess with him on that, man. I don't play man. But that 2K, I get in his head and I start to beat him. Yeah, man. But Florida had some guys that had he had 15. They had some guys with 29 points over there, 10 rebounds, 2 assists, the forward. They got a good team. Like, they got a real good team. It's the Collin guy, the one that they kept booing yesterday, Reggie, that was 6'11".
He was pretty good.
Yeah, he was pretty good, man. That man had 29 points yesterday, bro.
He had a double-double.
Yeah, 10 points, 10 rebounds, 2 assists. Like,
they won last night, right?
Who, Alabama?
Yeah,
Bama. Yeah, we won that thing now.
97-69.
Wow.
Like, to score 52 points in the first half for a college game, that is huge. Like, that is huge. Then you go back and score 45 the next half.
I understand how they don't showcase them like they do other colleges.
To my Alabama?
Yeah.
It's kind of always been like that. Like, I remember, like, when I was in school.
But they're good.
Yeah. Because I remember when I was in school, like, I felt like everybody else got the press that we didn't get.
Yeah.
And it was like, okay, like, wow. And that made me work harder because it's like, bro, like, we should be on this commercial. We should be on this platform. Like, why is everybody else on these commercials and we're not? Like, why are they getting this recognition? But I understand, too, like, you don't always want that target on your back also. Mm-hmm. And Bama basketball just become, you know, I want to say a good team, but mm-hmm. a consistent team over the last 2 to 3 years.
So they're just not kind of getting on the radar, so to speak.
Okay. Yeah. And they doing a great job, man. Something bothered me last night, though, Reg. I was reading, and they were saying that, you know, Alabama was the best athletic school around. Then I seen something on a post was saying, you know, what was better, Alabama basketball or football? A lot of people were saying Alabama basketball. And I'm like, come on now, don't listen.
Now or in general?
Like, I don't know, was it now or
in
general?
I'm thinking they're talking about just now.
Even if it's now, it still ain't better than, you know, listen, all our sports
run together.
They
haven't made it to the Final Four yet, which I hope they do.
All our sports run together. And listen, we cheer our basketball team on.
Yeah.
But let's not put too much dip on your chip.
Mm-hmm.
Best believe now, we're going to always be a football school first. And definitely, you know, basketball, we love our basketball. And I think
not even better than softball yet.
Yeah. I mean, because even,
softball,
you got
tomorrow.
Gymnastics. You got gymnastics too, man. We always been in gymnastics school or even golf. We done had some of the best golfers in the world come through Alabama.
What was it, 2011 or 12, when y'all had 5 national championships across the board?
Yeah, that was my last year. That was 2012. Well, 11, 12.
So in all sports.
Yeah, so we had gymnastics, golf, softball, football, and I want to say hockey.
Even the wheelchair basketball team's been winning some.
Oh, like, wheelchair basketball. We have always been good at wheelchair basketball.
Everything.
Oh, yeah.
Always, yeah.
Oh, yeah. If you're smart, when you're athletic, I definitely would wish people would look like, you know, look at the Bama, all the athletics. That's like, even with track, I mean, what's the guy named? Tony something. He was like the fastest 200 runner or the 400 runner in the world.
But it's like they're flying under the radar.
He won the 400.
Yeah, with the 400. Is it Tony? Was it Tony?
It's Alani, I think. Jelani James, I think.
Yeah, I know he was from a different country too, wasn't he?
Yeah, he won the Olympics, but the Olympics before, I think, right before we got out of school. No, this past Olympics, he won the 400.
400 meter.
Gold medal.
I'm pulling up right here.
Yeah, there you go. There you go, right there.
But like Cameroon,
400 meter. Yeah, when you think about athletics, bro. Like, I think Alabama, for now, definitely over the last 10 years, 15, dang near 17, 18, been most consistent when it came to all sports. And that's tough to do. That's tough to win in 2 sports.
You know who got the most national championships in the school?
Talking about at Alabama?
Mm-hmm.
Is it the wheelchair? No, it ain't the wheelchair team.
You said the most championships?
The most national championships.
National championships.
Mm-hmm.
Smitty.
I can pull up. I'm letting you guess. If I had to guess, I mean, obviously I want to say football, but for some reason I'm going to feel like I'm wrong.
Me too.
You are. It ain't football.
Track and field?
Softball?
Speech and debate.
No, gymnastics. Got to be gymnastics.
Oh, yeah, speech. Yes. I remember you
said speech.
Weren't you talking to somebody?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, speech and debate.
Speech and debate. I'm going to say debate.
Oh.
Nice.
Okay.
Okay. They on the A game with everything.
I debate you to death.
I love debates.
I debate you. I'll tell you something. 35, 35, 35. I debate you by numbers.
That sounds like bidding.
Debate the bid. Tomato, tomato. Well, listen, man, we got to pay some bills, man.
Playing the band music.
Yeah, man, listen, y'all go check out some of our great sponsors, man. Eggers.
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 Don't put the N in it.
Eggers.
Edgars.
Eggers. Bakery.
Edgars.
We had that chicken salad yesterday.
Man, what boiled it up?
And you know what?
He had a chicken salad yesterday.
I look out for y'all when I But when I came in here yesterday, saw empty bags. I was like, did they bring me anything?
Listen,
like,
I didn't get to treat me like
a bald head stepchild.
Wait a minute, because okay. I bring food and snacks all the time.
What happened yesterday?
I ain't bringing it.
Oh, who brought it?
Who sat right there yesterday? I ain't pointing no fingers.
Okay. So you brought food, but you didn't bring me nothing.
Hold on, Trent.
I'm saying he bought food for himself.
Oh, okay. I thought he bought.
Are we going to say it like Trent had their honey bun and the Gatorade?
Wait a minute.
But he brings stuff I don't eat.
I have honey buns for everybody. They just don't eat them.
I don't eat honey buns.
I'm on Jack. Drop on that. I like this.
Listen, man, Eggers is down there hiring too, man. Listen, if y'all want to make some good money, man, have fun and eat like at the same time, you might want to go check them out, bro. They're hiring right now at all locations, but they're looking for some great workers. They're not just going to hire anybody off the street. Now, you got to be qualified. Yeah, well, not even qualified. You got to have a good personality and
That's part of the qualification.
Yeah, I guess qualifications. But make sure, man, if you go down there, tell them Trent sent you, man, and they might give you a hug. So
that king cake was
amazing, though. Speaking of king, I can't wait, because you ain't even give me no props on that king cake, because I gave you that king cake with the little baby and the bees.
I forgot. Thank you. I forgot about that. My bad. Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Listen, we'll be right back with the ropes with TR3.
Live from ABX Studios in downtown Birmingham, The Ropes with TR3.
Inspired by quality ingredients and excellent service, Eggers Bakery has been a staple of Alabamian celebrations since 1998. What started as a small neighborhood bakery, founded by Terry and Dottie Smith in Birmingham, has expanded to 10 locations throughout Alabama. Eggers Bakery offers hot, delicious breakfast and lunch options in addition to grab-and-go deli items. They offer a wide range of pastries and desserts, including cookies, bars, brownies, cakes, cupcakes, and much more, made entirely from scratch using fresh, natural ingredients. Shop for gifts and merchandise in-store, including everyday and seasonal home decor items. Eggers has something for everyone. They also offer catering, shipping, and delivery options. Visit their website today at eggersbakery.com or stop by a location near you.
Walk On Sports Bistro puts everything they've got into bringing you game day with a taste of Louisiana. Dig into their mouth-watering, made-from-scratch Louisiana dishes or fan favorites like juicy burgers and fresh salads, all in front of 70-plus TVs with more than 40 beers on tap. Watching at home? Walk-Ons is available to go. Order online or through the Walk-Ons mobile app. Visit Walk-Ons in Tuscaloosa, Hoover, Montgomery, and Mobile. Walk On Sports Bistro, more than a restaurant.
Hey, Birmingham. Thinking about making your next move? The Randy Brooks team at Avast Realty is ready to help you with your real estate needs. If it's buying or selling, they have the tools and expertise to get you from for sale to sold. Whether you're looking in the city or want space to stretch out, call us at 205-965-6645. That's 205-965-6645. Real estate is key to building long-term wealth, so call the Randy Brooks team at 205-965-6645 and let's get you from for sale to sold today. 205-965-6645. Your dream has an address. Let's find it. New construction home searching can be challenging for buyers. The solution is the Avast Realty New Construction Home Team at 205-965-6645. Their relationships with the top new home builders in the state means they have the most up-to-date information on new home inventory. And as your buyer agent, the Avast Realty New Home Construction Team will give you 1% of our commission to use towards your new home purchase. So put the knowledge, expertise, and professionalism of the team to work for you and contact the Avast Realty New Construction Team at 205-965-6645 today. Again, that's 205-965-6645. Call today because your new home is waiting. Commission share disclosed on sales contract and closing statement.
Excuse me, do you know how long halftime is for a Crimson Tide football game?
15 minutes?
12 minutes?
18 minutes?
I'm pretty sure 12 minutes.
Actually, halftime at Alabama lasts 20 minutes. Any idea how long it takes to complete a mortgage application?
An hour and a half.
Probably like 3 hours at least.
It takes a couple days.
I'm going to go with 45 minutes.
Actually, at Assurance Financial, you can apply for a mortgage in less time than halftime. Find out more by visiting them at assurancemortgage.com. That's assurancemortgage.com.
Equal housing opportunity, NMLS 70876.
Call Chase Brooks at 205-612-4046.
Because, man, the Tide looks so good against the Gators right
out
of the gate.
No, we came out ready to go, and it was one of those where we hadn't played well at the start against LSU, and we said we got to have a better start. So I think we scored on our first three possessions. So, you know, getting the three from Brandon out of the gate helped. You know, we just ball moved, transition was good. We got found shooters open. You know, Sears, Brandon. We got Brandon, obviously, they were down pretty good this game. So we had a nice dunk there, some nice threes. He played well.
I'm not sure, Coach, I've seen many guys who are clearly a star at his level who blend in the course of a ball game, not disappear, but blend in with their teammates. And I guess it helps when you got a guy like Mark Sears who can pick up the load at any moment.
Yeah, I know Mark's been shooting it well, too. It's been great to see Mark play. But you're right about Brandon. I mean, he's a great team player, can pass the ball, can do it a little bit earlier. As can Mark. Mark gets downhill, finishes strong at the rim. Gets fouled a decent amount, makes threes at high clip, can kind of play the one and two both, finds our bigs on rolls. So it's good to get him back shooting it well, playing better. We need everybody clicking on all cylinders here.
Coach Oates over there, man. Next matchup, we got Alabama Auburn basketball team. Auburn has a 17-6 record. They've been playing good ball this year too. They got a solid team, man. It just took some tough losses. They lost against Tennessee last week, by 3 points. Right now, Tennessee is nationally ranked number 6 in the nation. They was ranked number 4 until last night. They lost last night with a tough loss to Vanderbilt. Which is a rival game, 65-66 in Vanderbilt.
That was close.
Yeah, last.
They're jumping and stoning and saying,
Mm-hmm. Then they lost to Florida, too. February the 1st, they lost against Florida. Then they came back and beat Auburn on the 4th by 3 points. But they lost to Florida 54-67. But they beat Texas 71-82, and Texas are currently ranked right now number 5 in the nation.
They games still be close though.
Yeah.
There ain't no blowouts.
Yeah, they games be really close. Yeah. But they got a solid team over there when you talk about Tennessee. But I can't wait. In 2 weeks. Well, no, they got Alabama. No, in a week, next week, they got Alabama on the 15th.
Here?
The day after Valentine's Day.
Here or away?
It is.
We'll be in Knoxville.
Oh. In Knoxville.
Tennessee.
But they got to get past Missouri first, and they got them on 11. That's this Saturday. But Alabama can't look ahead. You know, we got Auburn. We know how the rivalry is between Alabama and Auburn. And it's definitely not as big as the football rivalry.
I was going to say, is it as bad or no?
It's a tough rivalry, though.
Is this a big rivalry for basketball?
When are they playing?
They're playing this Saturday.
Oh, away or here?
We play over there at the Jungle.
Yeah, I won't be participating in that game. I'll be watching that from the sizzle, from the house. They don't like my kind down there in Auburn.
Why?
What you mean, why?
Oh, never mind.
Reggie, they like your kind down there in the Auburn, man?
Never mind.
Nah.
Did you see that Instagram? I sent you that clip where they threw that beer on Jalen.
No, that wasn't a beer. They said it was a beer. It was a football they threw at Jalen.
No, threw the football first and then a beer afterwards.
Oh, I didn't see
Watch
that.
Watch it. Yeah.
No, I didn't see that.
And that's why I was saying that, you know, we should talk about how, like, you know, abusive fans, like, how they need to get banned from games. Because that wasn't even necessary.
They threw a beer at Jalen?
Right here. Look at the screen. First was the football and then beer. Almost hit him. Watch. Oh, he went past it. Yeah, see, it fell. You couldn't see it, but
oh wow,
on the Instagram you can see.
See, but it's stuff like that, man. Like,
so
if we react to that, who gonna get in trouble? Who's gonna get fined? And like, come on,
did
bro.
He even kick that player out or anything?
Like,
I mean, the fan.
Like, what can we do? And we done had this conversation before, and I don't think
we
done had it on this. Did we have it on this?
We talked about it briefly, like in the first week of the show or something. Well, we need to revisit that.
Yeah, when it comes to fans, man, especially the cruel ones, right? Mm-hmm. The ones that do stuff to, you know, throw stuff at you or, you know, call you every name in the book except for the ones that's in the Bible. Like, Reg, like, I know you done had this happen to you before, you know, as far as disrespect from the fans. Like, where is the security for the athletes?
That's my question.
What happened? Say that again.
Where is the security for the athletes? You know, when you come to these fans.
They don't care about athletes for real, for real. That's why they feel like they can say whatever to them and keep them off the tennis. That's why I'm glad Bo went down there and scored that touchdown and threw his hand in that damn Tennessee fan face. Mm-hmm. Y'all remember that?
Oh, yeah, I definitely remember that.
And then when y'all go off on them, then y'all are in the wrong, and I don't get that.
Yeah, then we wrong.
What if you hit it? What if he had got hit with that? I beat the brakes off of him. I'm sorry.
Yeah,
they wouldn't have done nothing.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. if Jalen reacts to that, right, Jalen get fined. He probably get kicked out probably for the rest of the year or something. They would do anything to get him kicked out for the Super Bowl or – you
so
know, just to put some on his name.
Antagonizing
him. Oh, yeah.
Right.
Oh, yeah.
And that's the thing, like Philly fans, too. They don't.
Philly fans don't play. Mm-hmm.
I wish anyone.
I don't think about fan storming.
That's just like playing at like LSU.
I'm sorry, Rich.
I said that's just like playing at LSU. Man, like, wait on fans. Mm-hmm. Yeah, man, my dad didn't sit down. We had to fight somebody.
Them LSU fans, something new.
Right. I hope and pray one day I come through and I see them trying my people. I'm catching a case. You tell my mama.
Crazy. It's over like.
But Reggie did beat the hell out of somebody.
Raiders. Raiders fans crazy too.
Oh, yeah. Raiders fans. Raiders fans go at it.
Ooh, they don't even care.
They
about
do, but it ain't nothing worse than them Eagles fans, though.
I don't know, man. Brown fans can be. They can get with you too now.
They do.
And win, lose, or draw, they gonna them Brown fans gonna be at the game.
What do y'all think about fans storming though? Like in basketball, do you ever get worried that a coach or a player is ever gonna get hurt with fans storming?
If a fan run into a player and the player react, he gets in trouble.
Yeah, but no one, like, the school might get fined, but you don't see any of the kids where it's like they can't come back. Or, you know, you don't see any of them getting in trouble, but you see a school getting fined.
And they don't give it. Like I said, they don't care about that.
Apparently they don't.
And as I get older, like, I'm starting to worry about them type of things. Like, mm-hmm. like far as, like, hit a game winner, or you beat a team that you ain't beat in years, and the fans storm the field or the court.
Yeah, because you don't know what
they got. Like, they could have done made a knife or, you know, whatever. They could do whatever they want. And
they can't really stop, like, a rush
yeah,
of people coming.
Yeah, that's scary, man. But you never see an Alabama fan rush the field. Because we're so, I want to say controlled, but you're so used to winning, and you're so, you know, we're so respectful as, you know, fans of the game, and we respect Coach Saban or, you know, Coach Oates, to where
they don't have to be extra.
Yeah,
like
this
that.
Is what we do. We know how to win. You know, it shouldn't be no storm in the
and
field.
Know how to act when we win.
Yeah, and you got to know how to
field goal
act
and
when
river. We win. You know with the Tennessee, how they put the field goal in the river?
Yeah, that was crazy.
What?
Yeah, when they beat us this year, they put the field goal post in the river.
They walked it out of the stadium. I can't remember if it was like a half mile or how far away it is. But they walked it out of the stadium, tossed it into the river just because. It's like, what are you celebrating?
Wow.
Boy, them folks crazy.
Because you got to think about it. They ain't beat us since I've been in school.
That's been a minute.
You said it a little too comfortable, like.
Sorry.
Fred Jordan. Sorry. Yeah, that's been a minute. Like.
But I was saying it like in your benefit. Like, uh-huh. It's been a long time since they won a game.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not saying it because I'm trying to say you won.
Mm-hmm. Okay. All
I'm
right.
Not saying that,
one more.
Sir.
You got one more throwing that, Lisa, and I'm gonna get you. Okay.
It wasn't intentional.
Oh, Lisa got one.
You took it that way.
Get money. These are good jokes. Okay.
Wait a minute. Where is that from?
We got to take a break. Listen, we got to get into the second hour. Reggie at this game. He could go eat this popcorn. He going to get this nachos and cheese.
Reggie been eating since we've been on the show.
I am. I'm going to sit over here, and I'm going to sit my butt down and be good.
Mm-hmm.
I think he done ate already.
And listen, we'll be right back with this second half of the show of The Ropes with TR3.
We'll be back.
Walk On Sports Bistro puts everything they've got into bringing you game day with a taste of Louisiana. Dig into their mouth-watering, made-from-scratch Louisiana dishes or fan favorites like juicy burgers and fresh salads, all in front of 70-plus TVs with more than 40 beers on tap. Watching at home? Walk On's is available to go. Order online or through the Walk On's mobile app. Visit Walk On's in Tuscaloosa, Hoover, Montgomery, and Mobile. Walk On Sports Bistro, more than a restaurant.
Hey Birmingham, thinking about making your next move? The Randy Brooks team at Avast Realty is ready to help you with your real estate needs. If it's buying or selling, they have the tools and expertise to get you from for sale to sold. Whether you're looking in the city or want space to stretch out, call us at 205-965-6645. That's 205-965-6645. Real estate is key to building long-term wealth, so call the Randy Brooks team at 205-965-6645 and let's get you from for sale to sold today. 205-965-6645. Your dream has an address. Let's find it.
Inspired by quality ingredients and excellent service, Eggers Bakery has been a staple of Alabamian celebrations since 1998. What started as a small neighborhood bakery, founded by Terry and Dottie Smith in Birmingham, has expanded to 10 locations throughout Alabama. Eggers Bakery offers hot, delicious breakfast and lunch options in addition to grab-and-go deli items. They offer a wide range of pastries and desserts, including cookies, bars, brownies, cakes, cupcakes, and much more, made entirely from scratch, using fresh, natural ingredients. Shop for gifts and merchandise in-store, including everyday and seasonal home decor items. Eggers has something for everyone. They also offer catering, shipping, and delivery options. Visit their website today at eggersbakery.com or stop by a location near you.
New construction home searching can be challenging for buyers. The solution is the Avast Realty New Construction Home Team at 205-965-6645. Their relationships with the top new home builders in the state means they have the most up-to-date information on new home inventory. And as your buyer agent, the Avast Realty New Home Construction Team will give you 1% of our commission to use towards your new home purchase. So put the knowledge, expertise, and professionalism of the team to work for you and contact the Avast Realty New Construction Team at 205-965-6645 today. Again, that's 205-965-6645. Call today because your new home is waiting. Commission share disclosed on sales contract and closing statement.
Fox Mortgage, NMLS, 184-762. Jim Corey, NMLS, 212-055.
Jim and his team at Fox Mortgage helped us to quickly purchase a house.
Debbie shares her Fox Mortgage success story.
We needed to do it. We actually bought my father's house. He needed the money to continue his care. He's in an assisted living facility. We applied online, and within a day or two, Jim called us, and it seems like probably a month or less later that we closed on the house. I would definitely recommend Jim Corey and Fox Mortgage. They helped us quickly buy the house, close on it, and he even went so far as to come to the assisted living facility where my father is to sign all the papers there.
Hi, I'm Jim Corey, president of Fox Mortgage. I'm ready to help you with your mortgage needs. Call now, 661-6868. Fox Mortgage, where we're quick as a fox.
92.5 WYDE FM Cordova, 1260 AM WYDE, 93.7 WDJC FM HD3 Birmingham, and 95.3 W237 EK Birmingham.
The Ropes with TR3. Two-time national champion. Three-time All-American. 2011 SEC Offensive Player of the Year, Heisman finalist, and Alabama's first Doak Walker Award winner with 49 touchdowns and 4,590 yards. Third pick of the 2012 NFL Draft to the Cleveland Browns. Also doing a stint with the Indianapolis Colts. Trent Richardson can do it all under the brightest lights, uniting legends of the game to show you the ropes. Train your body and mind with former Alabama wide receiver, 2009 national champion, Coach Mike McCoy. Develop a championship mentality with two-time national champion, 2015 SEC Player of the Year, Super Bowl winner with the Chiefs, Reggie Ragland. Featuring King of the Stage, comedian legend, Jermaine Funny Mane Johnson. And 1992 national champion, Antonio Langham. You are your way out. Live from AVX Studios in downtown Birmingham, The Ropes with TR3.
Man, I hate Tennessee because, first of all, it's Tennessee. And I just hate them because they low down, they dirty, they some snitches. And I hate Philip Fulmer. I hate their colors. I'm not a dog person. I just hate Tennessee, man. Like, and I hate Neyland Stadium. It looks like a garbage truck worker convention. And I hate all their quarterbacks. I hate Tennessee, man.
Describe what you feel about the colors, too. I
thought that was interesting. It reminds me, it's not that orange that you can stand. See, I hate Tennessee more than I hate Auburn. I just dislike Auburn. I hate Tennessee. See, Tennessee's colors is that throw-up orange. It's not that orange that you can sit with. It's that puke inside of a pumpkin orange. And I don't like pumpkins.
We are back. We'll just do Capco in the next segment. He was doing the orange. What was that, Smitty?
You never seen that with the Alabama fan?
Dude, you never seen that?
No.
I think it was maybe 14 years ago. Maybe not even that long. But there's an Alabama fan. Obviously, his disdain for Tennessee right there. He was interviewed by a student and just asked his thoughts.
He had a lot of thoughts. He said, I don't like pumpkins.
Yeah, he. It's a lot. Listen, it's a lot of people. Hate Tennessee more than they hate Auburn. That's Bama fans. Like, I can remember when I was getting recruited and I was somewhere out eating, and this guy kept saying, I hate Auburn. But if you run somebody over for Tennessee, man, I promise you, I'm going to love you forever. I remember that like it was yesterday.
This interview had almost a million views.
He looking serious, too.
I could only imagine whenever they saw you coming through Trent saying, hey, we're going to have – they called us trying to – so when they say snitching, they tried to say that we were cheating in the early 2000s. And they were one of the reasons why we couldn't go to the to postseason for a little bit.
Oh, because they were accusing you guys of cheating.
Yeah, they – listen, they hate Tennessee more than ever. Reg, have you seen some of the trades been going on, man?
Oh, lost the
he's at the game.
Listen, Mita, have you seen some of the trades been going on?
In the NFL or NBA?
NBA.
The Lakers, man, I'm just saying, I knew LeBron, he was a little questionable saying, you know, I wasn't trying to be too loud on it, but what do you think about Westbrook?
I don't know. Like, I feel like I would have.
What happened with Westbrook?
They traded Westbrook to Utah, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Utah, they traded him to?
What?
I feel like they should have got more, or they should have waited for somebody else to give up Westbrook. And, you know, I feel like Westbrook, he's still going to be a top 15 player in the NBA.
How long he been with the Lakers? He been with the Lakers for a good little minute, though, right?
No, he's been with the Lakers 2 years now.
That's it?
Yeah.
Wait. Who was he before? Where was he before?
He was with, was it Washington? Or was it Houston?
I'm looking now.
I'd look back.
Say it again.
I'd look back for Westbrook.
Yeah.
I can't remember who he was with before that, but I know it was.
Yeah, but I mean, his career in L.A. hasn't been what it was in OKC. And I think because everybody didn't see.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he went OKC, Houston, Washington, and then with the Lakers. So he just had that brief stint with Houston and Washington.
Yeah. So people didn't get to see him missing as many shots as he missed when he was with OKC. Cause it wasn't on a big screen like you are in LA. LA is the team that's on TV every night type caliber team. Yeah. Like it's like the Dallas Cowboys. Like growing up, all you seen was Dallas Cowboys, the Lakers, even the Raiders, and the New York Knicks or Chicago Bulls. Like that's all you seen growing up.
That's
so
true.
If you think about those type of markets and programs. Like, they're bigger than ever now. And so he's on the big stage every night. So he's going to get criticized way much more than he was when he was with OKC. And over the last 4 years, he's been on, what, four or five different teams. So
that should tell you something.
And I don't really think Westbrook got a problem. I just think that, you know, it's coming towards that, you know, the end of his, you know.
Retirement time.
Yeah, it's about retirement time. And, I mean, he's still playing good ball. I just think that, you know, he's got to be in control of his story. He got to be the narrator of everything that he does. And if they're not going to let him be Westbrook, then he don't need to be a part of that program. And that's how he was at OKC. They was letting him be Westbrook. And so he was able to do what he wanted to do and control the, you know, speed of the game. I mean, he's an MVP caliber player.
He's one of them quiet players.
He talk his mess now. But you gotta get underneath his skin, but he go at you and he'll let you know this is my house when he get to going now. especially young Westbrook.
Yeah.
Young Westbrook was.
Yeah, back in the day he was yeah. That's where I remember him from.
The Fox and the Ja Morants, they was, you know, both of them put together was, you know, Russell Westbrook. Talking about jumping out the gym, played at UCLA.
Do you think that he was seeking this so that way he could maybe get to a team to have more, I don't want to say spotlight, but because LeBron, he's looking too, you know, he's an assist-driven guy as well. But do you think he's looking for a team where he could get back to triple-doubles other than just getting on and helping LeBron win?
Yeah, I think he got put in a situation where he didn't know that he wasn't going to be the guy. Like, I think he felt like LeBron's come to the end of his career.
I know he didn't think that.
I mean, it's year 20 for LeBron, you know. Still. I mean, it was in year 19 when he joined them. And so I think he felt like, you know, I'm going to be a big part of the puzzle, in which I think that gave him an opportunity to be, you know, the big part of the puzzle.
Westbrook younger than LeBron? Oh, yeah. Really?
Yeah, he's younger than LeBron.
I thought he was older than LeBron.
No. He had the opportunity to, you know, be that guy. But I don't, you know, being in L.A., it's a lot of distractions, too, at the same time. And not saying that anything distracting him, but far as, you know, the temptations of life out there, other than just being an athlete, it's huge. Like, being a movie star, you know,
get caught up quick.
Different businesses or, you know, fashion and all of that. Like, he's an L.A. guy, you know, don't get me wrong, with, you know, the fashion designs he do and, you know, with the clothing that he wear, with him making appearances at places, like, that's, he's the L.A. type caliber guy. But when it comes to sports, man, he need to be in a system where he's away from everybody.
Yeah, not distracted.
And he can just play ball, you know. And
but he's used to it. He's from Long Beach.
Yeah, he can just play ball. And I think that at this time of his career, he's definitely want to get him a championship. And so, and I think that's why he joined LeBron, too, because I definitely thought he was going to get a championship. And, you know, on top of that, you know, if you think he's going to get a championship, we need you to be a part of this puzzle, and you're a big piece of this puzzle. Right. And so it just, you know, it's just kind of like a bad relationship. I wouldn't even say a bad marriage with them. It's just a bad relationship, man, you know. You get that, you know, that one chick or, you know, male, you know, they look good in the beginning and, you know, everything looked real good. Then you start to date them a little bit and all the, you know, good looks come to, you know, you start thinking about, okay, the conversation ain't going nowhere.
What else is it?
Yeah. You know, what else is it behind the beauty or the smile?
Yeah, I get what you're saying.
You know, so I think that's what it was. And I think, you know, for them, it's best to go their separate ways because at the end of the day, man, LeBron is trying to win another championship. You know, and I think he, you know, he's putting up points every night, 40 points a game, man, 35 to 40 points a game. At age, he's almost 40 years old, bro, like still doing it. And then he's not slowing down. He just broke another record.
I think it's your mindset. I never look like age to me don't really matter. It's your mindset. It's your stamina. And it's just how you carry yourself in general. You know, you could be a certain age, you decide you're going to sit down somewhere and not do nothing and just be that age. You get what I'm saying?
It's two sides to it.
It is, but it is a mindset, though, at the end of the day.
It is. When you play sports, it's different. Like, how? Everybody, because you got some guys can just ball, right? And
you just got to have your mental there.
Yeah, I'm saying you got to have your mental there, but just because you feel like you can do something, that grandfather clock hits you, and that's just not what your body can do. Your mind can do it, but your body is telling you no. Your body is telling you no.
I put a meme up like that. It said me. I feel 20 years old. It said my bones. I'm like, no, we don't.
Man,
so it's the same thing.
I mean, that's just like, man, look, you go out now, right? At your age, you go out now.
Why you say it like that?
Nah, even at my age, I go out now, right? That next day, I'm going to be feeling it. Far as, you know, my schedule going to be thrown off.
Yeah.
Like, when I left the game yesterday at Reggie, when I got to the house, I went slap asleep.
It changes.
Yeah, because, you know, that's out my norm. Like, that was out my norm. Like, I used to being asleep at a certain time or being in the house and being comfortable and winding down. Like,
and look, while you're out, that's all you're thinking about.
Yeah, like,
I can't wait to get on that couch. I get it.
That's all you're thinking about. Like, but, you know, I think it was time, you know. And I think it should have happened before then. But I think they tried to give him an opportunity to where, you know, it didn't tarnish his name because it had been a bad rep on him, you know, not being able to be a team player or a guy that can take the back seat and learn how to play with other big name guys.
He's been known to be difficult in that area.
Somewhere. I don't want to say being difficult, but some people don't know how to play with other big name stars. You know, it's going to be huge to see, you know, what Dallas do with Kyrie and Luka. So we don't know, nobody know how it feels for Luka to play with another big name superstar. You know, he's great with Dallas.
Yeah.
Right now, but he just got, you know, Kyrie over there, and Kyrie demands the ball. He's going to be that face of that program. And Luka, you know, he's going to always, you know, be a part of that, but he's not the main guy anymore. Like Forrest, you know, every night he's taking the ball down court.
Yeah.
He's controlling the game, the pace of the game. He's not that no more, because you have a guy like Kyrie that can do it too and been doing it for a way longer time and still the best point guard in the game right now. So it's just different. It's different. You know, it's guys have, you know, LeBron, everybody can't have a LeBron career. Everybody can't have the Tom Brady career. So, you know, even the Jordan career, like everybody don't have that, you know. It came a time when Jordan, you know, slowed down. You know, he felt like he could still do it. And just because he felt like he can do it with the Wizards doesn't mean it was going to happen. Yeah. Like, it didn't happen with the Wizards.
Yeah.
It didn't happen without Scottie. It didn't happen without, you know, that team that he had in Chicago.
Right.
Now, if he would have stayed with Chicago or they went and broke up that team,
it would have been impossible.
Another year, I definitely think that they would have got two or three more championships. And so just because that mind tells you, yeah, that mind's strong now. I get it. Hey, listen, that mind. But when you're playing sports, when that grandfather click time click in, shoot.
I agree with that.
Better believe it, baby, because that thing, them backs, them knees, that neck, fingers.
I was an athlete my whole life, and when you get to a certain age, all of that comes right back on you. And just like you said, the knees, the back, everything.
Yeah. Unless we got some bills to pay, we'll be right back with the Ropes with TR3.
We'll be back.
Live from AVX Studios in downtown Birmingham, the Ropes with TR3.
Join a team you know and love at WDJC and WXJC. We're looking for a part-time receptionist and assistant to the office manager to share your enthusiasm and skills with us. This position is multifaceted, from helping WDJC and WXJC listeners, advertisers, and broadcast partners, to performing a variety of administrative duties. If you're eager to serve and have a heart for ministry, apply today and earn the extra cash you need. We offer competitive pay at a company that's making a difference. See the full job description at WDJCOnline.com. Send your resume to LDS@CrawfordMediaGroup.net. That's LDIAZ at CrawfordMediaGroup.net. If you qualify for this position, our office manager, Lesvia Diaz, will set up an interview with you. Crawford Media Group is an equal opportunity employer.
Inspired by quality ingredients and excellent service, Eggers Bakery has been a staple of Alabamian celebrations since 1998. What started as a small neighborhood bakery, founded by Terry and Dottie Smith in Birmingham, has expanded to 10 locations throughout Alabama. Eggers Bakery offers hot, delicious breakfast and lunch options in addition to grab-and-go deli items. They offer a wide range of pastries and desserts, including cookies, bars, brownies, cakes, cupcakes, and much more, made entirely from scratch, using fresh, natural ingredients. Shop for gifts and merchandise in-store, including everyday and seasonal home decor items. Eggers has something for everyone. They also offer catering, shipping, and delivery options. Visit their website today at eggersbakery.com or stop by a location near you.
Walk On Sports Bistro puts everything they've got into bringing you game day with a taste of Louisiana. Dig into their mouth-watering, made-from-scratch Louisiana dishes or fan favorites like juicy burgers and fresh salads, all in front of 70-plus TVs with more than 40 beers on tap. Watching at home? Walk-Ons is available to go. Order online or through the Walk-Ons mobile app. Visit Walk-Ons in Tuscaloosa, Hoover, Montgomery, and Mobile. Walk On Sports Bistro, more than a restaurant.
Hey, Birmingham, thinking about making your next move? The Randy Brooks team at Avast Realty is ready to help you with your real estate needs. If it's buying or selling, they have the tools and expertise to get you from for sale to sold. Whether you're looking in the city or want space to stretch out, call us at 205-965-6645. That's 205-965-6645. Real estate is key to building long-term wealth, so call the Randy Brooks team at 205-965-6645 and let's get you from for sale to sold today. 205-965-6645. Your dream has an address. Let's find it. New construction home searching can be challenging for buyers. The solution is the Avast Realty New Construction Home Team at 205-965-6645. Their relationships with the top new home builders in the state means they have the most up-to-date information on new home inventory. And as your buyer agent, the Avast Realty New Home Construction Team will give you 1% of our commission to use towards your new home purchase. So put the knowledge, expertise, and professionalism of the team to work for you and contact the Avast Realty New Construction Team at 205-965-6645 today. Again, that's 205-965-6645. Call today because your new home is waiting. Commission share disclosed on sales contract and closing statement.
Excuse me, do you know how long halftime is for a Crimson Tide football game?
15 minutes?
12 minutes?
18 minutes? I'm pretty sure 12 minutes.
Actually, halftime at Alabama lasts 20 minutes. Any idea how long it takes to complete a mortgage application?
An hour and a half.
Probably like 3 hours at least.
It takes a couple days.
I'm going to go with 45 minutes.
Actually, at Assurance Financial, you can apply for a mortgage in less time than halftime. Find out more by visiting them at AssuranceMortgage.com. That's AssuranceMortgage.com.
Equal housing opportunity, NMLS 70876.
Call Chase Brooks at 205-612-4046.
Welcome back to The Ropes with TR3. And before we go into our next segment, let's talk a little bit about Cabco. Cabco is the number one builders for manufactured homes. And if you are looking for one, give us a call or come visit us at one of our locations here in Alabama. Those locations are... One second. We have...
Tell them what you got, Lisa. Come on.
What we got? J&J Homes. Thank you. In Coleman. Repo Land in Albertville. Oxford Housing. We have Freedom Homes in Jasper. Miller Homes in Opelika. Discount Home Sales in Enterprise. Spartan in Summerdale. Daystar in Sylacauga in Clanton. And always remember, Cabco Builders, where quality comes first. You still got to take me to that factory, though. I want to check it out. See how they build them. And back to you, sir.
Yes, ma'am. Talk about these trades, man. Smitty, you had text me something, man. You said, you know, you feel bad for Jason Kidd. Why do you feel bad for Jason Kidd?
Yeah, what happened now?
And what coach, and tell folks where he's coaching at.
So if I wasn't mistaken, was he with the Nets before everything happened with Curry?
I thought Jason is with Dallas, right?
That's why I just want to say, because whoever was with Durant and Kyrie, well, now with both of them traded away, that's who I feel bad for. Because he lost his job heading into the season. And now both of them aren't even on the same team.
Well, I know Steve Nash was over there.
Steve, okay, yes.
Yeah, Steve Nash is over there. Yeah, so right now Jason... Jason in a good position. He got Dallas over. He got Kyrie over there with him. But yeah, Steve Nash, bro. Like they, you know, actually, I think Steve Nash got thrown into the fire with making him a head coach. Like fresh, you know, fresh out of playing. You know, not even, you know, fresh out of playing, but he's been a couple years out of playing, and he ain't really had no coaching experience as far as, you know, on a big team or a head coaching job, and they just gave that man a head coach, and they should have gave that head coaching job to Mark Jackson if they were smart. But Jason Kidd right now, bro, he's going to be perfect for Kyrie. And I think that he's really made a big impact on Luka. Everybody know that, you know, the way Luka played and the way he passed the ball lately over the last couple of years has been, hey, if you know Jason Kidd and you know what he's done for the game,
he's a legend.
But the way he assists the ball, like it would be another, it'll never be another Jason Kidd, mm-mm. You know.
He used to be one of my favorite players.
One of the biggest impacts on the game when it comes to, you know, having assists, being able to shoot the three at the same time, being able to control the game, being a true point guard, and that can get buckets. Jason Kidd has been one of the biggest stars when it came to NBA basketball.
Now, why do you think he's going to be a good fit as a coach for Kyrie?
They played the same position. You got to think about it. Jason Kidd was he ended up winning his last championship, and he won the championship in 2011. Mm-hmm. He's a 10-time NBA star. All-star, I'm sorry, 1996, 1998, 2000, 2004, 2007, 2008, 2010, five-time All-NBA first team, 2002 and 2004. All-NBA second team, 2003, four times.
Well, dang.
Yeah, four times All-Defense, NBA All-Defense first team, 1999, 2001, 2002,
okay.
And 2006. Five-time NBA All-Defense second team in 2000, 2003, 2004, 2005, and 2007. NBA.
I'm tired listening to that.
And listen, NBA co-rookie of the year in 1995. NBA All-Star rookie first team 1995. Five-time NBA assist leader 1999, 2000. 2001, 2003, 2004.
Dang. Is that it?
No. It list goes on. Two-time sportsmanship award winner in 2012 and 2013. USA basketball male athlete of the year in 2007.
That it?
No. NBA 75th anniversary team. That's big.
That it?
Number five, retired by Brooklyn Nets, his number five jersey.
Mm-hmm.
Like,
that it?
Nah, it's not.
Goodness.
Like, he was an All-American. Yeah, he was an All-American in basketball in college in 1994. Like, we can keep going on and on.
I didn't
on.
Even know he was 49. I thought he was.
He got two Olympic gold medals in 2000.
Yeah, he got two Olympic. Yeah,
oh,
two-time first team parade All-American.
He got a portfolio.
Two-time California Mr. Basketball 1991, 1992, National High School Player of the Year 1992, McDonald's All-American 1992.
God.
Like, we can go on and on. Like, they retired his basketball jersey at the California Golden Bears. Yeah,
good.
NCAA season steal leader in 1993, NCAA season assist leader in 1994, Pac-10 freshman of the year.
That's crazy.
In 1993, Pac-10 player of the year in 1994. Like, that list goes on and on.
He did all that.
As assistant coach, you got an NBA championship of 2020. Like, we can
is
keep going.
That it? No. Like, no.
We can keep going. Like, it's so much Jason Kidd has done for the game. And he's been around some big-time programs and
definitely
able to put people in the right situation. I think he's just going to enhance Kyrie Irving's career and make it, you know, and even make him even much better of a player. Like, and he's already been a dog within itself. But the stuff that Kyrie's going to be able to do and learn and soak up from him, I mean, he just came from Steve Nash. Steve Nash was a great too.
Yeah, Steve
and
Nash.
So to soak up that.
Another favorite player.
And then you go and be able to soak up even more of a legend, you know, with Jason Kidd, it's going to be crazy.
Oh, yeah.
It's going to be crazy, and I can't wait to see what his career take off at from here. But it's going to be one of them type careers that you look at Chris Paul or you look at Magic Johnson, and you look at some of them guys that came before Kyrie, and you think, you know, the Isaiah Thomases and stuff like that, think like, oh, man, those guys changed the game. Like, and to this, and Kyrie has been the best point guard for a long time, and he still is. He really got my respect in that championship game when he hit the game. That shot against Steph Curry, man, that changed the whole outcome for them being down 3-1, and it's never been done before in the championship game series, and brought them guys back, man, and he was a big part of that championship that they – you know, have in Cleveland. Yeah.
That's what's up. I didn't know his pedigree was that long.
It was wild reading back is that
impressive.
He actually watched Kidd playing. So whenever he was growing up, one of the first games he went to in fourth grade.
I didn't think about that.
It said that he got to watch Kidd play. So now he's being coached by him. Yeah, one of the first guys that he wanted to emulate in the league.
Talk about a dream come true. Wow.
Just a kid living his dream right now, man. Just a kid in the candy store right now.
Who did you watch as a kid and then finally got to meet him in person? You were kind of like,
oh, man.
Trent Richardson.
Listen. Oh, man. It's a lot.
The number one, top one.
Ricky Williams for me. Mm-hmm. Like, Ricky Williams is always my favorite player. Growing up, got to watch him. That's the reason I wanted to go to Texas, because of him. Mm-hmm. But meeting him, Vince Young, like, and I was like, flabbergasted. Yeah, when I met Vince Young, and I met him at the Playboy Mansion, and it was just like, I'm shaking his hand, like, bro.
Well, that's
like,
another story.
Nah, it was a party, but it was just like, bro, like,
okay.
What is this?
Instead of looking at all the. What was going on? Like, I was like, bro, you know who you is? I'm like, bro, you're Vince Young. Like, I literally played with you on NCAA growing up. Like, bro, like, this is Vince Young. Like, and I'm tapping my brother. My brother, like, bro, you good? But, like, we both was, like, just fans
speechless.
Of him. Yeah, speechless, because it's like, it's the guy I used to, you know, play the video game for, you know, with. And so, him, got to meet Kobe, LeBron. Emmitt Smith, of course, Derrick Brooks.
That's what I was going to ask you, because he's from Pensacola. Did you meet him?
Yeah.
You just named out Kobe and LeBron, just like, nah, you know, I just
like
met some
of
the guys.
Right? You see how he just breezed by it? Yeah, Kobe, LeBron, yeah.
And it was crazy.
Police.
Yeah, it was crazy to meet LeBron, because LeBron had called me over, because LeBron had came to my game at Bama when they had the lockout, him, D-Wade, I think Rick Ross was there. I don't know if Chris Bosh was there, but I know him and D Wade was there. That came down to the game of the century. We played against LSU. And he had left me a message and stuff, man. I done met a lot. Lil Wayne, Baby, Busta Rhymes.
But look, you've been in the game for a minute. So.
Yeah, I done met a lot of folks, but a lot of folks don't realize, like, a lot of these folks are Bama fans. Like,
really?
A lot, like Ricky, even Ricky Smiley, like,
Well, I
like
know
he was
is.
A big one for
I
me.
I know he is.
Yeah, meeting him, like, he was a big one for me.
Ricky's a huge Alabama fan.
Who he had with him when I met him? He had Dr. Dre.
Oh,
Dre.
Wow. Mm-hmm.
He had Dre with him.
Yeah.
So, Snoop. I can name guys for days.
So you were in L.A. for a little bit. Seems like it.
I wouldn't. I mean, I go out there and visit. Suge Knight was huge. Like, far as meeting, like that was big, meeting Suge. And knowing that, like, he really messed with me. Like, I can tell y'all a funny story about Suge. When we come back, I know we got to take a break. But we had some guys scared.
He's big as he look on TV.
Yeah, Suge got good size on now. Yeah. He got a little bitty legs, but he got his upper body pretty big.
He skipped leg day.
Yeah, he definitely skipped leg day. But I got a funny story about Suge Knight when we get back, man. We got to pay some bills, man. So listen, we'll be right back with the Ropes with TR3.
We'll be back.
Inspired by quality ingredients and excellent service, Eggers Bakery has been a staple of Alabamian celebrations since 1998. What started as a small neighborhood bakery, founded by Terry and Dottie Smith in Birmingham, has expanded to 10 locations throughout Alabama. Eggers Bakery offers hot, delicious breakfast and lunch options in addition to grab-and-go deli items. They offer a wide range of pastries and desserts, including cookies, bars, brownies, cakes, cupcakes, and much more, made entirely from scratch using fresh natural ingredients. Shop for gifts and merchandise in store, including everyday and seasonal home decor items. Eggers has something for everyone. They also offer catering, shipping, and delivery options. Visit their website today at eggersbakery.com or stop by a location near you.
Walk On Sports Bistro puts everything they've got into bringing you game day with a taste of Louisiana. Dig into their mouth-watering, made-from-scratch Louisiana dishes or fan favorites like juicy burgers and fresh salads, all in front of 70-plus TVs with more than 40 beers on tap. Watching at home? Walk-Ons is available to go. Order online or through the Walk-Ons mobile app. Visit Walk-Ons in Tuscaloosa, Hoover, Montgomery, and Mobile. Walk-On Sports Bistro, more than a restaurant.
Hey, Birmingham. Thinking about making your next move? The Randy Brooks team at Avast Realty is ready to help you with your real estate needs. If it's buying or selling, they have the tools and expertise to get you from for sale to sold. Whether you're looking in the city or want space to stretch out, call us at 205-965-6645. That's 205-965-6645. Real estate is key to building long-term wealth, so call the Randy Brooks team at 205-965-6645, and let's get you from for sale to sold today. 205-965-6645. Your dream has an address. Let's find it. New construction home searching can be challenging for buyers. The solution is the Avast Realty New Construction Home Team at 205-965-6645. Their relationships with the top new home builders in the state means they have the most up-to-date information on new home inventory. And as your buyer agent, the Avast Realty New Home Construction Team will give you 1% of our commission to use towards your new home purchase. So put the knowledge, expertise, and professionalism of the team to work for you and contact the Avast Realty New Construction Team at 205-965-6645 today. Again, that's 205-965-6645. Call today because your new home is waiting. Commission share disclosed on sales contract and closing statement.
Excuse me, do you know how long halftime is for a Crimson Tide football game?
15 minutes?
12 minutes?
18 minutes? I'm pretty sure 12 minutes.
Actually, halftime at Alabama lasts 20 minutes. Any idea how long it takes to complete a mortgage application?
An hour and a half.
Probably like 3 hours at least.
It takes a couple days.
I'm going to go with 45 minutes.
Actually, at Assurance Financial, you can apply for a mortgage in less time than halftime. Find out more by visiting them at assurancemortgage.com. That's assurancemortgage.com.
Equal housing opportunity, NMLS 70876.
Call Chase Brooks at 205-612-4046.
Welcome back to The Ropes with TR3, with your number one legend, Trent Richardson. I want to hear the story now. Who is that? That's you?
Yeah, that's you.
Goodness. Like a truck.
So, my jeweler.
Jake?
Nah, hell no. Nah. Not one Jake. No.
You sure?
You said Jake or Jay?
Jake, the jeweler.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. That was everybody's jeweler.
So my jeweler, but my personal jeweler was Jaime. Jaime is Tupac's best friend.
Mm-hmm.
And so we're out in L.A. and, you know, I'm asking about, you know, just, you know, the L.A. life. And I'm looking at him like, bro, why do you look just like Suge? I'm like, bro, you know, it's like, you know, that's my guy, man, you know. And I figured that out, you know, mm-hmm. him being Tupac's best friend and stuff like that.
Yeah.
And so we're sitting there talking about him, and they call him up. I'm like, bro, where you at? And so as he calling him up, we're walking through the mall, mm-hmm. and we see him. And so he's sitting there, you know, I met him and talking to him and stuff mm-hmm. like that. But we go into, I think we're going to Foot Locker, right?
Mm-hmm.
And Suge up there talking mess to me. And he say, man, you know, we running 40 right now. I beat you for the first 10 yards. My first 10 steps, man, shoot. I'm gonna whoop you. And so I say, man, Suge.
He can run.
You know, Suge used to play football.
Oh, he just big, though. He just don't look like he got the speed on him.
Yeah, he played football. You know, them linemen, them first 10 steps for a lineman be, you know, real fast. They get off as real strong.
Okay.
And so we're sitting there talking, and I say, Shook, I can't let you whoop me, cuz, in front of everybody. He said, you know, everybody done heard it now. So, man, listen, that definitely can't happen. So Shook say, well, that's when we just get rid of everybody. And so. So
everybody with the running.
Man, listen, it's so funny because we in Foot Locker and a guy the worker say, well, that's just when I just leave up out here. I ain't hear nothing. And he go running.
Y'all can have all these shoes.
And so we bust out laughing, like, bro, these folks are funny.
But they are afraid of him.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah. Listen, a lot of people talk mess about Suge, right? And so Suge hung with me, you know, pretty
tough.
He's not
as bad as people think he is.
Man, Suge a good dude. Now, I would say, when you put your hand on him, because he was telling, and Jaime was telling me a story about Suge, you know, when they mm-hmm. used to, you know, rough folks up back in the day. He said, man, he put his hand on your shoulder. And he say, man, let me holler at you, home, but let me holler at you, my dog.
It's over.
Yeah, it's over with. It's over with. He put his hand around your shoulder like that. I mean, he finna whoop you.
How tall is he?
Suge about 6'4", 6'5". So when me and Suge talking, he put his hand around my shoulder. I'm like, all right, Suge, not, you know, I done moved my shoulder. Like, all right, bro.
And
so Jaime go laughing. Jaime laugh, my brother laugh, because they already know what I'm doing. Like, I'm moving. Right, all right, like, bro. Like, all right.
Go ahead.
But he just, you know, he just, you know, being friendly, talking with me and stuff. You know, right. We just having a conversation.
He's intimidating, though.
Yeah, I mean, to a lot of folks, just because of the rep. But mm-hmm. Suge don't bother nobody, man. Like, Suge, mm-hmm. a lot of people talk about doing stuff to Suge. Suge hang with, he'll have two or three females with him. And that's, he ain't got no bodyguard with him.
He don't need one.
Nah.
He's his own bodyguard.
Yeah, and you can talk all that mess about Suge and say what you would do and all this other stuff.
Yeah.
Suge is not fazed by none of that. Like, he is his own man.
How much
like,
longer do he have in...
I don't know. Suge, good dude, though. I tell you that. Like, a lot of people give him a hard time for some old stuff, or, you know, for him taking up for himself, or, you know, him being a, you know, producer. Like, him being, you know, that name of Death Row. Like, him being that guy.
You know, his son was on a real estate show
recently.
He was trying to be a realtor, and he said he was trying to take over L.A., being the top realtor. Mm-hmm. I don't know how long. I think it's just like one season, but he was pretty good on it.
Man, we was out in L.A., right? And it was around my birthday time.
Mm-hmm.
And so we are at the Rookie Symposium, and Suge, you know, had called me like, well, yeah. I'm like, you know, I'm at this spot, you know, blase, blase. And this is right before Kendrick Lamar came out.
Mm-hmm.
And so when Kendrick Lamar comes, he's, you know, at this time he's, you know, playing a little gigs to, you know, get his music out.
Yeah.
And so Suge showed up to the event. He just pulled up on us. And so it was a guy, you know, Suge coming there with his cigar and everything. And it was a guy was like, hey, you got to get up out of here. And he was one of the bouncers because, you know, he came and Suge like, hey, bro, you can't do that in here, blase, blase.
Smoking a cigar.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Next thing you know, they're escorting the bouncer out the club.
What?
Yeah.
He like got that much pull.
Man, listen. Dang. And he didn't even have to say. He just looked at him.
Wow.
He, you know, Suge walking around with his shades on. He just looked at him like this. Mm-hmm. And next thing you know, the other bouncers are getting him out of the club. Dang. And it was just like, sheesh.
Wow.
Listen, so.
That's clout.
Nah, the funniest story, right? We're in L.A. Mm-hmm. And I'm going to tell you that story later. Hold on. Because I'm going to talk about Jamie Foxx threw me a party for my birthday, right?
What?
Yeah, Jamie Foxx threw me a party for my birthday.
I'm sorry, you writing a book. That's over. It's over.
He threw me a party for my birthday, and everybody came out. Like he,
in L.A.?
Yeah, in L.A. Uh-huh. And this was put together like in 30 minutes. And so my jeweler called him up, Jamie up, and he's like, hey, man, got a little bro in town. You know, it's mm-hmm. his birthday. He tell him who I was. He's like, oh, man, I'm a big fan, blase, blase. And next thing you know, we pull up to this little place to go eat, mm-hmm. and it's 50 girls at the table. And it's me and Jamie, and this is the time he was doing Django.
Yeah. Oh. Mm.
And so he was had the beard going. Yeah, he had the beard going. Yeah. And at this time, Jamie was still in character for a lot of this script, like off script. Like he was still being character. Yeah, he had his hat on. Yeah. He had his hat on.
Goodbye to Miss Laura.
Yeah, like that's how Jamie, you know.
Yeah.
And Jamie got real big hands, right? So he shook my hands. His hand about the same size as mine. He's got mm-hmm. real big hands. Mm-hmm. But Jamie is skinny. Like Jamie is like
really?
Small. Yeah, he's like, well, at this time, like I don't know, was it for the movie? Well, but he's small.
Is he tall?
Nah, Jamie about my height. He might be a little bit shorter than me.
Oh wow.
So we're sitting there. He got everybody, you know, he got every girl to come around, give me a hug, tell me happy birthday.
Yeah.
And they start singing happy birthday to me and everything. He had me a cake and everything. I'm just like at all because
and he
it's
just
Jamie
put that together
Fox.
In that short period of time.
Yeah.
That's bull too.
And it's me, my brother, one of my best friends out there. And so we take a picture and this picture, I got it in my phone. And this picture, like he got the phone, his guy got the phone on the ground. Mm-hmm. And it's like us standing over it, like around the camera, looking down at the
camera. That's so cool
like he has a real cool picture.
Yeah.
But we're comparing, like I don't know if I had on shorts or something, but you told he put his leg next to mine and they took a picture of it, and his leg looked like a little pixie stick compared to mine. He's right. Like, yeah, that's why I went to singing and acting, and didn't pursue my football career because you know Jamie was a good football player too.
Yeah. Oh, I know, I saw him on Any Given Sunday.
Yeah,
I was out there.
Listen, he tell you a story about that. That was funny because him and LL Cool J got into it for real.
I was there. I was for the Marlins.
Yeah, you did tell me about that.
Yeah.
You did tell me about that.
I was there.
Yeah, they got into it for real.
And you don't believe who won.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. Jamie throw them things.
Throw them hands.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So we at the club. So he take me out to the club later on that day.
Yeah.
And they had me drinking on drink. And so, like... The guy from Blindside was there. The one that played Michael Dyer. Mm-hmm. Michael Dyer. I think it's Mike. Yeah, Mike. The guy from Blindside.
The big dude.
Yeah, the big dude. Yeah. He was there. Yeah, Michael Orr. Jaleel White was there.
Really?
Yeah, Jaleel White was there. Not
Urkel.
Biggie, the guy that played Biggie in the Taurus movie, he was there. Yeah. D-Ray was there.
All the people
was
here for your birthday party.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
What's the guy name off of the one that played young Michael Jackson off the American Dream, the one that played Smart Guy Brother.
Yeah. Oh God, I know who you're talking about. Smitty, look that up.
He was on the video with Chingy.
I know who you're talking about. I see his face, but I can't get his name.
Oh, man.
So, anyway, all these people were
all these people are there. And, like, it was a great time. A great time. And so, I say, man, listen, I'm finna go back to the room. Mm-hmm. And so, this is a story going into Suge. Suge ended up showing up, too. Mm-hmm. But Suge them went somewhere else, and a couple of my guys went with them, like, mm-hmm. far as football players. Because we still out there for the rookie symposium.
Yeah.
So there's a whole bunch of rookies out there. Mm-hmm. And so, like, they know I had got real cool with Suge. And so this was probably, like, the second or third time I done actually really chilled with Suge. Mm-hmm. And so at the time, you know, we're pretty cool with each other. So we out there. And so my guy, it was Alshon Jeffrey. He got drafted to the Bears. And it was Kendall Wright. He got drafted to the Eagles. No, to the Titans. He got drafted to the Titans.
And this year you were with Cleveland, right?
Yeah. Okay. It was my rookie year. I ain't played a snap yet. So
getting all that love.
Yeah, getting all this love. And so when they do all this, it's about time for my birthday time, right?
Yeah.
And so they go somewhere else. I think they went to go eat or something, whatever they went. They went and Shug fell asleep. And so and it was like four. It was what's my guy from Arkansas played in Minnesota, but it was like four guys that I came in with, right?
Uh-huh.
And we was all tight, and Shug fell asleep, and so now I'm back at the room, and they all calling me like, bro, and this is before Uber. Like this is
a cab.
Yeah, this is like before, like cab. This is when Uber had Mighty just
started,
was going to kick off.
Yeah, yeah.
But it was before Uber, right when it was going to kick off. And so they was like, hey, bro, like, hey, Shug fell asleep. Like, can you come get us, or can you send somebody to come get us?
Mm-hmm.
So I'm like, bro, wake him up. And so they all say,
they were scared to wake him up.
Hell nah, we ain't touching Shug. Like, what is wrong with you? And so when Shug fall asleep everywhere he go. Like, he just got that old man syndrome. Oh,
he got narcolepsy.
Yeah, he dang got narcolepsy, right? Mm. And if he sit down for a good second, he sleep. He
wow.
sleep.
He got narcolepsy.
So I'm like, bro, if y'all don't wake this man up, like, bro, we're not touching him. Like, like, what you don't understand? It's Shug Knight. I'm like, bro, wake the man up. And still to this day, I don't know how they got back to the room, because we never talked about it after that.
I was going to ask you, did you have to come and wake him up?
No, I wasn't. Listen, I wasn't coming. I was in the room. And so I wasn't coming to wake this man up either. But they were so scared to touch him to, like, hey, man, we ready to go home. Because I had already asked him. I was like, bro, y'all sure y'all want to go back to the room with us?
I was stuck at the club with him. Didn't
want to
wake
him up. I'm like, bro, y'all sure? Now, nah, we're going to go. We're going to go. And so she's like, man, they good, little bro. Like, you know, I got them.
Yeah.
So I'm like, all right, cool. She'll fall asleep.
They never told you what happened?
Nah. They never told me what happened.
I wonder how they get
back. I don't know how they got back.
I think he probably woke up eventually.
I don't know, but they were scared to touch him. And so I'm like, man.
Probably stayed close till the lights came off.
Yeah, so I'm like, homie, bro. Like, they scared. They were like, man, tell them, wake him up. And so they were scared to wake him up. And so it was another time I'm in L.A., this is a different time. And so Shug ended up leaving his wallet at the house.
Yeah.
And so his old lady's at the house. And he had a couple chicks with him. He was like, hey. He had just called Jaime. He was like, Jaime, I need to get a room.
Yeah.
You know, hey, go ahead and throw me the bread if I can get the room.
Yeah.
You know, I got you.
Because he left his wallet.
And so he like, hell no, I ain't giving him the money. I'm like, bro, why you not going to give Shug Knight the money? He's like, because I know Shug. That's like my brother. He ain't going to give me the money back. He might give you the money back. He ain't going to give me the money back. And so I gave him like $300 to get a room. Like, bro, here you go. Like, that's Shug Knight, you know? Like, who can say that they gave Shug some money to get a room?
I guess somebody listened to the show. They just text somebody. They better not wake Shug up.
They definitely ain't waking Shug up. Like, wow. But Shug was cool, man. Like, even when I got out the league, like, Shug would call me and check up on me, like, just on some big brothers type stuff, like, keeping me motivated, like, or keep working, keep going at it, you know.
Have you ever tried to get in touch with him since he's been in?
No, I haven't. Mm-hmm. I don't know how to get in touch with somebody when they're in. Mm-hmm. Usually, you know, they find a way to get in touch with you.
True.
But Shug has always been a good person to me. Like, I don't know everybody else's situation with him, but he, like, even the chef, like, so Shug's chef was Devontae, play for Oregon. They used to call him Black Mamba, for football, play with Oregon. What his name is? Devontae, Smitty, what's the fast guy that played at Oregon?
D'Anthony Thomas.
So Shug's chef was D'Anthony Thomas. And so even when he would have problems, D'Anthony would have problems with his family or, you know, what was going on, or, you know, he didn't think he was going to get drafted. Like, he'll call me, like, hey, man, talk to my nephew. Like, you know, I need you to take him underneath his wing.
Yeah.
And so, like, even, Snoop would, like, tell you, like, bro, that's a cool dude. Like,
he just seemed like he cool, too.
Oh, yeah, Snoop cool as hell.
That's another story for another day.
Like, Snoop is cool. He's everything that, you know, he think he is, that people say he is,
yeah.
Times 10, like, one of the most humblest person in it, like,
he seems
ever.
Like, he seems genuine.
Like, every time he come to Birmingham, he called me, let me know he here, come out to the concert. Mm-hmm. Last time he was here, we got invited to their football league, my little league program.
I forgot he had a football league, too.
Oh, yeah. He, Coach Snoop, man, he big with little league sports. I gave one of my Birmingham Iron jackets. Mm-hmm. Cause at the time Birmingham Iron was going on, and
he would
to the concert,
mm-hmm.
And so the whole time, man, like, he's out there wearing, he's repping the Birmingham Iron jacket, and I'm like, bro, that's yours. Like, he tried to get it back to me.
Yeah,
like, that's yours. But I'm sitting next to Snoop. I'm high off secondhand. Man, listen. Snoop passed them things. Now he smoke.
He stay lit.
Oh, yeah, but he's the only guy. Snoop has been the only guy and the first guy I've ever seen, yeah. Like, just walk around with a joint in his ear.
And nobody bothering
him. In the Staples Center at the time. He went in the Crypto Center.
Yeah.
In L.A. and talking stuff to the players. Like, hey, Paul Gasol, get your tail on the dang board. Like, crash the West Common.
And talking about
smoking, like, and firing it up in the Staples Center. Like,
and nobody said
nobody. Wow. Nobody say nothing to him.
That's pull too.
Oh, yeah.
That's pull too.
And listen, man, we're going to get into it tomorrow maybe, or this another time we can talk about these Snoop stories, because I definitely got a lot of them.
Now we doing that book.
But, yeah, we're gonna do a book one day, man. Definitely. Listen. Definitely. Well, we got to wrap it up. You know, once again, you know, I want to thank everybody for joining me, my co-host, the one and only Reggie Ragland, and definitely thanks to everybody else, man. Thank you to Smitty. Thank you to Miss Lisa over here, man.
You're
on
welcome.
The ones and twos.
Anytime.
And I want to thank you to all the listeners, man. If you enjoyed the show, please share and post about us on social media. Also, The Ropes. Follow The Ropes with TR3 on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, Bama Insider, or YouTube. And catch all the shows if you missed them on Spotify. Tune in tomorrow for another great show. We're going to finish off the week strong with more great conversation. And you have been listening to The Ropes with TR3. I'm your host, the one and only Trent Richardson. And always remember, you are your way out.
Good night. Look at you out here playing with the urn. Look at it.
Again, that's 205-965-6645. Call today because your new home is waiting. Commission shared, disclosed on sales contract and